Hello.
Will I be audible? Am I audible? Am I audible? My esteemed brother and sister judges, the learned advocate general state of West Bengal, the learned additional solicitor general, government of India, the president and secretary of the Bar Library Club, the president and secretary of the Bar Association, the president and secretary of the Incorporated Law Society, learned members of the bar, and members of the families who are present here. We have assembled to mourn the demise of Sri Pranab Mukherjee, the former President of India, and Sri Kashikant Maitra, Senior Advocate of this court. Sri Pranab Mukherjee passed away on 31st August 2020. He was 84. He was born in a village in Bengal Presidency of British India, now in Birbhum district of West Bengal. After graduating in law, he taught in Kolkata and also worked as a journalist before entering politics. He was a member of the bar and went on to make his glorious presence in national level politics and government for over five decades. He was a statesman of the highest order and maintained profound precision and dignity of every office he held. He had mastery in governance and inbuilt capacity to effectively handle issues in political and public life of the people of this great land. His sharp memory and excellent managerial skills provided immense inspiration to those who were and are part of governance from different political backgrounds. He had the rare distinction to smoothly carry forward the functions amidst the change of political government while he was in the Rashtrapati in office of governance. He was honored by conferring Bharat Ratna. In his death, we have lost a great personality and human being who always stood as a guiding beacon for the coming generations. Sri Kashikant Maitra passed away on 30th August 2020 at the age of 95 years. His achievements glittered with honesty, integrity, complete commitment and dedication. I understand that Mr. Maitra evinced experience, expertise and great skill in various fields of law. He was a leader of the bar in the appellate jurisdiction of this court. His contribution to the field of law is well reflected in the innumerable reported judgments of cases which he argued. Mr. Maitra's achievements were not confined only to the field of law. He was actively involved in political as well as social activities. His contribution enriched Indian polity. He was polite, soft-spoken and very considerate to the young lawyers whom he always helped with his valuable guidance. I am informed that Mr. Maitra often said that glory and greatness of an institution like law and judiciary depends on the continued meaningful performance with grace and dignity, inspired by high and rich traditions consistent with its dignity, utility, prestige, and that every member of the bench at the bar must ensure that nothing is done to impair the same. In the death of Mr. Maitra, we have lost a stalwart of legal fraternity. His death undoubtedly is a grievous loss to all of us. My brother and sister judges and I express our profound sorrow on the demise of Sri Pranab Mukherjee and Sri Kashikant Maitra. We offer our heartfelt condolences to the members of the bereaved families and pray that the Almighty bestow upon them the strength to bear the irreparable loss.
My Lord, the Honourable the Chief Justice, My Lord Justice Banerjee, My Lord Justice Mukherjee, My Lords attending this program online, My Lord Justice Dipankar Dutta, Chief Justice Bombay High Court, members of the Bar, President and Secretary of Bar Library Club, President, Secretary of the Bar Association, President and Secretary of the Incorporated Law Society, ladies and gentlemen, members of the registry and all attending this program. The COVID-19 pandemic is costing the Indian citizenry too much. We have lost two great sons of the soil in this week. One Mr. Pranab Mukherjee and other Mr. Kashikanta Moitra. In losing Mr. Pranab Mukherjee, we have lost, or the Indian citizenry has lost, the Chanakya of the country, the crisis manager of the country, a big statesman, and a person of various qualities. Mr. Pranab Mukherjee is known to everybody. I need not introduce you to him to anyone present in this program. He had a political career of more than 5 decades, and finally he renounced politics and became the 13th president of our country. He had been the minister in several cabinets, and finally held the highest constitutional post of our country. My Lord, Mr. Pranab Mukherjee was known for several qualities. He was a great teacher. He was a great student. He had an elephantine memory and vast, vast, vast knowledge of in all subjects. He could speak in various subjects simultaneously without a pause. Starting his career as a teacher, he had finally adorned the highest post, constitutional post of our country. Well, there will be no end in speaking about the qualities of Mr. Pranab Mukherjee. He was author of so many books, mostly on politics. And I would like to share the last words of Mr. Pranab Mukherjee while describing Indian nationhood and democracy. Mr. Pranab Mukherjee had described democracy by saying that Indian democracy is built on 3 D's: debate, discussion, and dissent. I don't think our Indian democracy can be described in such a lucid, single, short sentence as he has described Indian democracy in through his 3 D's. The other thing that I like very much of Mr. Pranab Mukherjee is how he described Indian nationhood. He said that the soul of India resides in pluralism and celebration of the diversity. He said Indian nationhood is not one language or one religion or one enemy. He described it as a perennial universalism of 1.3 billion people speaking in 122 languages. In 1,600 dialects, practicing 7 major religions, belonging to 3 major ethnic groups, and living under one flag, one system, with one identity, that is Bharatiya, and no enemies. This is how he described Indian nationhood, that Bharat is a diversity, unity, and united nation in diversity. Lord, he was a person of endless qualities. I cannot describe. An insignificant man like me cannot speak much about his quality. He has left us, he has left the Indian nation, he has left his family of son, daughter and his grandchildren. I pray to God that his soul rest in peace. The other great man that we have lost is Mr. Kashikanta Moitra, who had pursued, according to me, two full-time professions simultaneously. He was a great politician on the one hand, and we have also seen him to be one of the finest lawyers that our Calcutta High Court has seen. A doyen at the bar, he was the son of a great Sanskrit pandit, great pandit Lakshmikant Moitra, who was a member of the Constituent Assembly who shaped our Indian Constitution. Mr. Kashikanta Moitra hailed from Krishnanagar, and he had contested the election in the West Bengal State Assembly. On 6 occasions, he was elected, and he was minister in the cabinet of Ajoy Mukherjee and Mr. Siddhartha Shankar Ray. And finally, he gave up politics and he concentrated on practice. Now, from day one of my profession, I had found Mr. Kashikanta Moitra to be a great lawyer with great oratory skill and command over the language as well as the subject in which he used to argue. He had got one peculiarity, which I don't think I have seen any other learned members of the bar following. He had his exercise books. Whenever he used to study a case, he used to note it in his exercise book and bring that exercise book in court and argue from there. He told me that he had retained all the exercise books that he had from day one of his profession, and I hope that he'll maintain his library. Beloved, his thirst and quest for knowledge was unparalleled. I remember when I was having barely 10 to 12 years of practice, I was arguing a matter before an honorable single judge in a service matter, in a disciplinary proceeding matter, when Mr. Kashikanta Moitra was sitting in the room. After a few days, he called me at his bar association room number 4 and told me, "Kishore, I found you arguing a matter on so and so date. I have got a similar matter. Kindly give me the citations that you have, the judgments that you have cited before the judge." Well, this was his quest for knowledge, thirst for knowledge. He did not mind even calling a raw junior almost, and to take his assistance for arguing a matter. So these are the high qualities of great men like Mr. Kashikanta Moitra. Apart from his politics and profession, he had authored a number of books, mostly on politics. And my lord, he has lived his life. The one thing which I remember about him is, which I have not heard from anybody, he used to say, "Kishore, if I die, I rue about one thing. All the knowledge that I have acquired will go to the ashes. It will be a waste the day I die." But I wish, my lord, he had lived longer. He has left us at the ripe age of maybe about 95 or 96 years. Lord, Mr. Kashikanta Moitra will be remembered in the corridors of the Calcutta High Court. My lord, he has left behind his wife, his son's family. Lord, I wish and hope and pray to God that his soul may rest in eternal peace. Thank you.
Honorable Chief Justice, Justices Banerjee and Mukherjee, other honorable judges attending this reference, President, Secretaries and members of the Committee of the Three Associations, ladies and gentlemen. Mr. Pranab Mukherjee, 13th President of India, breathed his last on August 31st, 2020, aged 84 years. Born in Mirati, a village in Birbhum district, Mr. Mukherjee obtained his master's degrees in history and political science and a degree in law from the University of Calcutta. He worked as an upper division clerk in the office of the Deputy Accountant General, West Bengal, and even taught political science in a well-known college. In between, he had some stints as a journalist. Mr. Mukherjee did not begin his career in politics in the Congress Party. It was Ojoy Mukherjee, leader of the breakaway Bangla Congress, White Minister of Bengal, as the head of the United Front government, who introduced him to politics. Mr. Mukherjee's first foray in politics came in 1969, when he successfully managed the election campaign of V. Krishna Menon, the Congress stalwart who had been denied in 1967 a ticket from the South Bombay constituency, which he had then represented as an independent candidate from Midnapur. Mr. Pranab Mukherjee had been sent to Parliament to Rajya Sabha in 1969 on a Bangla Congress ticket. It was there that he caught the eye of Indira Gandhi. Mr. Mukherjee had joined the Congress in 1970, and in 1973 he had been appointed a deputy minister. In October 1974, he was appointed Minister of State in the Finance Ministry. His big break came later when, 6 months into the emergency, he was appointed Minister of State with independent charge of a newly created Department of Revenue and Banking, tasked with implementing draconian laws to deal with economic offences like FERA, COFFIPOSA and the Foreign Contribution Regulation Act. Mr. Pranab Mukherjee had excelled at his job. He enjoyed the patronage of and his efficiency and loyalty made him one of Indira Gandhi's confidants during the emergency and the difficult times that followed. After the debacle of the 1977 elections, when the Congress split in 1978 and several prominent congressmen left, he remained true and loyal to Indira Gandhi. After the landslide victory of the Congress in 1980, he was given the ministries of Commerce, Steel and Mines, and subsequently Finance, and was recognized as the number two in the Congress party. After the assassination of Indira Gandhi in 1984, Rajiv Gandhi had taken over as the Prime Minister. Mr. Pranab Mukherjee, in his own words, was shell-shocked to find that he had been dropped from the cabinet and later removed from all key party posts, and eventually in 1986 expelled from the party. Mr. Mukherjee attributed this to the fact that the novice Prime Minister probably felt threatened by his presence and had given ear to the vicious, spiteful and malicious canards that Mr. Mukherjee had immediately after Indira Gandhi's death attempted to have himself appointed caretaker Prime Minister. Mr. Mukherjee had established a new political party, the Rashtriya Samajwadi Congress, but had merged the same with the Congress party in 1989. Success had followed, and he had been appointed Deputy Chairman of the Planning Commission and subsequently Ministers for Defence, External Affairs and Finance. It was his skilled negotiations as Minister for External Affairs which enabled India and the United States of America to enter into the successful nuclear policy. In 2007, he expressed a desire to become president of the nation. Rumor has it that Mrs. Sonia Gandhi had called him on one night and asked him to take one person in the party who could represent, and the party would back his candidature. And when Mr. Mukherjee could not, the matter ended. In 2012, Mr. Pranab Mukherjee filed his nomination for the post of president, and on July 25, 2012, had been elected the 13th president of India. As the president of India, he had become bipartisan, his only guiding light being the welfare of the nation. Mr. Narendra Modi had acknowledged that when he came to Delhi in 2014, Mr. Mukherjee had his hand and guided his early steps. Mr. Pranab Mukherjee had demitted his office in 2016, and failing health possibly weighed heavily on his decision not to seek another term in office. In 2019, the government of India had bestowed on him the highest civilian award, the Bharat Ratna. In August 2020, he had been hospitalized, and following complications resulting from the removal of a tumor in his brain, he breathed his last on August 31, 2020. His sudden and unfortunate demise has left a void which will be difficult. May God give his family the strength to bear this loss. Rest in peace, Pranab Mukherjee. We have today the sad duty of condoling the death of Shri Kashikanto Moitro, senior advocate of this court, renowned jurist, politician, and the senior most member of the Bar Association of the High Court at Calcutta, who passed away on August 29, 2020. Kashikanto Moitro was born in Pabna district of Bangladesh on 18th of February 2025. After receiving his school education at Shantipur in Nadia, he had completed his BA degree from Krishnagar College in Nadia and passed his MA in economics from Calcutta University. He obtained his law degree at Calcutta Law College and enrolled in the Calcutta High Court. Kashikanto Moitro's father, Lakshikanto Moitro, was a renowned politician and a member of the Constituent Assembly. He had been elected an MP from Krishnagar. Kashikanto Moitro followed his father's footsteps and had been elected to the Legislative Assembly in 1961, 67, 69, 1972, and 1977. In 1967, he had become a minister of the United Front government in the Department of Food Supply, but had resigned before completion of his tenure due to differences of opinion. His speech in 1975 was a mark of protest of the declaration of emergency was memorable. By 1982, he had given up active politics and immersed himself in the legal profession, practicing exclusively in the writ courts. He developed a flourishing practice, was soon appointed senior advocate of this court, and his masterful handling of facts and oratory stood him in good stead against the number of luminaries of this court. He was a source of inspiration to many. Kashikanto Moitro had continued in practice till just before the pandemic. Kashikanto Moitro's demise has left this honorable court without its senior most member and has created a vacuum that will be difficult to fill. May God bless his family and give them the strength to bear his loss. Rest in peace, Kashikanto Moitro.
Mr. Moitro, if you please can make this.
Anita, please unmute yourself. Sir, please unmute yourself.
Oh, now, all right. Thank you. My Lord the Chief Justice, my Lords, the members of the bar, you have joined this full court. We are here to mourn the sad demise of two eminent persons. Firstly, Mr. Pranab Mukherjee, I adopt the address of the Advocate General and don't like to repeat his eminent career and different posts he held from time to time, are known to all of you, have been fully publicized and chronicled in the media. I like to remember him. And as a son of Bengal, who has made us all proud, he was the first Bengali to adorn the post of President of India. He was the second Bengali who got Bharat Ratna during his lifetime. He held various posts. But I'd like to remember him as a Bengali who remained steeped in Bengali culture, rooted in Bengal, although he attained highest post of the country. This is the first time in my career, in my living memory, I find that the national flag has remained and will remain half mast for 7 days for death of a Bengali. We have seen Mr. Mukherjee from a distance. Now let me refer to a person whom we have all seen from a close distance. We have assembled here to mourn the demise of late Kashikanta Maitra, a person, you have come to remember a person who had combination of manifold personalities, political, administrator, lawyer, and last and not the least, a perfect gentleman. He remained MLA for several terms, a minister, and he was senior most lawyer of the bar when he died. I have seen him in his heydays as a lawyer, assiduous, a very thorough lawyer, without any fear or seeking any favor. Gradually, he slowed down in his practice with advent of age, and particularly after death of his eminent doctor son. But he continued regularly visiting the court and handled legal matters from time to time. He was Kashida to all of us, to all members of the bar. He was loving and affectionate towards all members of the bar, irrespective of their standing. And in return, he was loved by all. A man of no ego, although he had every reason to be proud of himself, he remained humble, modest, and affectionate to all of us. I do remember and will remember for the rest of my life the affection and love he has shown to me, And on behalf of Ballabhi Club, I offer condolence to members of his family and pray that his soul may rest in peace. On behalf of Ballabhi Club, I also pray that may the soul of Mr. Pranab Mukherjee also rest in peace.
My Lord, the Chief Justice of Calcutta High Court, My Lord, the Chief Justice of Bombay High Court, My Lord, Mr. Justice Banerjee, My Lord, Mr. Justice Mukherjee, My Lords, the Learned Advocate General, the Learned Additional Solicitor General, the President and Secretary of the Bar Library Club, the President and Secretary of Incorporated Law Society, and my colleagues from the Bar Association, members of the registry and others present. My Lord, more than 12,000 members of the Bar Association High Court Calcutta join me in paying our most respectful respect and homage to Sri Pranab Mukherjee, former President of India and Bharat Ratna, and our very own Sri Kashi Kant Moitro. My Lord, undoubtedly, the demise of Sri Pranab Mukherjee is a great national loss. But for the members of the High Court Bar Association, it is also a great personal loss. From the year 1987 till his death, he was a member of the Calcutta High Court Bar Association. He was one of the greatest members of the Calcutta High Court Bar Association. My Lord, we are trying to trace out his application for signed by him to become a member of the Bar Association. If we are able to trace out the application, I'll most humbly beseech my Lord the Chief Justice to make some arrangement for permanent preservation of this document, because this shows that the President of India had made an application to the High Court Organization Bar Association to become a member. My personal memory of him goes back to the year 1970, when he attended a meeting of high-profile intellectuals. At that time, he was merely a first-time member of the Rajya Sabha on behalf of Bangla Congress. I distinctly remember that I was completely mesmerized by his charisma as a speaker before such a gathering, and by his absolute and exceptional mastery of the English language. I pray that his soul may rest in peace. Now, coming to Sri Kashi Kant Moitro, he was the senior most member of the High Court Bar Association, and the age of more than 95. He was a father figure to all of us. Whenever any advocate known to him wished him, he generally blessed them by placing it on his forehead. My Lord, though he was a doyen amongst Kolkata advocates, he did not have even the slightest sense of vanity and pride. He was down to earth in his dealings, even with junior most advocates. I remember one incident. An absolutely new advocate got his first brief and engaged him as his senior. The case was over. The client paid his fees. Then Sri Moitro called that advocate, asked him, "This is your first brief." Then he gave him some money. From the court, boys, take to the market, purchase one sari for your mother, one Punjabi for your father. Go home, touch their feet and get their blessings. That junior advocate today is a designated senior advocate of the Calcutta High Court. Not till his death, he retained an exceptionally sharp memory and was totally mentally alert, though he had become a little weak physically. In the month of April 2019, we had organized a legal training program for advocates in the High Court auditorium. We requested him to kindly come and inaugurate, and if the subject was constitution, we requested him to speak a few words about constitution if he has permitted. He came attended by an attendant and a nurse because he was not well. We thought that he will speak for 1 or 2 minutes. When he took the mic, he said, "Today's subject is constitution." Yes. He started speaking, dealing with various provisions of the constitution, various cases, mentioning the reference also without any note. After 10 minutes, the nurse called me down and said that his health is not good, please stop him, let him not continue. I told him, "Now let us see." After another 10 minutes, the nurse said, "Either you stop him or I'll come on the stage and stop him." Then really we had to force him to stop and requested him to go to the sofa. My lord, for our personal loss, each and every member of the Bar Association is greatly saddened. We request that his soul may rest in peace. Thank you.
My lord, the Honorable Chief Justice, the Honorable Judges, the Learned Advocate General of the State of West Bengal, the Learned Additional Solicitor General, Government of India, Learned President and Secretary, Bar Association, Learned President and Secretary of Bar Library Club, on behalf of Incorporated Law Society, I address you on a very sad occasion. That is this reference to mourn the sad demise of two stalwarts in the country's political history. It is one is former President of India and Bharat Ratna, Sri Pranab Mukherjee, and Sri Kashikanta Moitro, a former minister of our state, a six-time MLA, and a very respected and senior lawyer of our court. Sri Pranab Mukherjee was born in the year 1935 in Miriti, Birbhum. He started his career as a college teacher. He started his political career as a founder member of Bangla Congress. He became a member of Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha in the year in July 1969 on Bangla Congress ticket. The then Prime Minister of India, Mrs. Indira Gandhi, recognized his talents and she recruited him to her party, the Indian National Congress. He was re-elected to the House in 1975, 1981, 1993 and 1999. He became a member of the Lok Sabha in 2004 from Jangipur constituency. He was called the modern Chanakya in Indian politics. In 1979, Sri Mukherjee became the deputy leader of Indian National Congress in the Rajya Sabha. And in 1980, he was appointed the leader of the house. His rise was rapid in early phases of career, and he rose through a series of cabinet posts. Sri Mukherjee was considered to be one of the top-ranking Indian cabinet ministers, serving multiple ministries. And he presided over cabinet meetings also in the absence of the Prime Minister from the country. Soon after the assassination of Mrs. Indira Gandhi, he lost his position in the cabinet and was sent to manage the regional West Bengal Pradesh Congress Committee. In 1986, he founded another party, namely Rashtriya Samajwadi Congress in West Bengal. His political career revived following the assassination of Rajiv Gandhi in 1991. when Mr. P.V. Narasimha Rao chose to appoint him as Deputy Chairman of the Indian Planning Commission and subsequently as a Union Cabinet Minister. He served as the External Affairs Minister for the first time from 1995 to 1996 in Mr. Rao's cabinet. So Pranab Mukherjee held many important posts in Manmohan Singh government also. He was awarded Padma Vibhushan, India's second highest civilian award in 2008. He retired from active political life following his election as President of India in 2012. In 2017, he decided not to run for re-election and to retire from politics after leaving the presidency. In the year 2019, he was awarded India's highest civilian honor, the Bharat Ratna, by the President of India. He was a very learned man and he had knowledge in almost every subject. He was a very shrewd and practical man in life. His end came at the age of 85. It is a personal loss to the people of the state. Sri Kashikanta Moitro, another doyen, although he was away from the active politics in recent times, but he was very active in the legal world till the other day. Whether it was the legislative assembly, the arena of politics, the legal boundaries or discussion meetings, the eloquent Kashikanta Moitro had a special attraction. He was associated with politics through his family sources. His father, late Lakshmikant Moitro, was a member of the Constituent Assembly in the pre-independence period. He was later elected to the Lok Sabha from Krishnanagar. Later, his son, Kashikant Moitro, entered the State Assembly, also from Krishnanagar East Centre, in the year 1962, as a Praja Socialist Party candidate. He later became a two-time MLA in the years 1967 and 69 on the United Socialist Party ticket. Kashikanta Moitro was an independent candidate from Krishnanagar East Center in the year 1971. This time he won the support of the Congress. The following year, in 1972, he was elected as a Congress candidate again and became a Minister of Food and Animal Husbandry in the cabinet of late Siddhartha Shankar Ray. He thereafter resigned from the ministry when the allegation of a scandal was leveled against him. His said decision to step down from the cabinet on moral grounds is still remembered as an exemplary step. He became an MLA once again in 1977, this time as a Janata Party candidate. So Kashikanta Moitro was a member of the legal profession for more than 56 years. He was a leading counsel in constitutional matters. His argument was always very eloquent. He had a very voluminous practice. Apart from that, he was a very avid reader of literature. His recitation of Tagore was excellent. The entire legal fraternity is very sad by reason of his demise. On behalf of my society, I pray to God that the departed souls may rest in eternal peace. Our heartfelt condolences to the bereaved families. I remain, my Lord.
As a mark of respect to the departed, let us observe silence for a minute. proceedings of this court shall remain suspended for the rest of the day.